So in the world of eye tracking, we spend a lot of time looking at fixations and saccades. Can you just tell us a little bit about the difference between them, what it actually means?
Okay, so when we fixate on something, our eye is directed at it, but we may only have good fixation. Only one eye might be fixating on a target and the other eye might be decentered, or as we call it, squinting. So it's good to know which eye the child is fixing with. Saccades are eye movements from one target to another. You can't actually make a saccade easily without having two targets to look between. So you can't make that quick movement if you haven't got any issues with development. For children with complex needs, very often they struggle to make accurate saccades. So what that means is they'll look from one target to another, but their eyes might overshoot slightly, or you might see that they move their head to try and get their eyes to come over, and it will take seconds sometimes, or certainly moments, to actually move the eyes to the target. So it must be incredibly frustrating for kids sometimes when we're impatiently getting them to look at something, and by the time they've actually found it, we're on to something else, and they're always one step behind. So something I have to say to myself when I'm watching a child is wait for eight, and I'll actually count out 8 seconds to see if they can make a saccade in that time.
During the while a saccade is happening, at that time you have like a lower resolution image on the retina. Is that right? So you're not actually resolving like high definition detail at that point in time. It's the fixations that provide the high resolution image.
Exactly. So when we fixate on something, we're directing our macula, which is the part of the retina where you have the high density of rods, which are the photoreceptors that are responsible for our most detailed vision. So in order to get really good 20/20 vision, you need to be fixating with a stationary eye on the target to get that level of vision. So as you say, when your eye's moving, the resolution is lower. So a child with nystagmus, for example, who can't steady their eye, won't have perfect resolution because they're not able to direct the macula, that central part of the retina, to fixate on a target.